Wifibooth is packed with features that help guests receive their photos as easily and quickly as possible. Guests that share their photos generate important buzz for your business. Two of those features are the email and Dropbox functions. Wifibooth will send email and upload to Dropbox right away if it is connected to the internet. And the great news is that if you don't have internet access at your event, Wifibooth will automatically send them later when internet access is detected. We know your brand is important to you, so there are lots of opportunities to customize both the email content and the in-app prompts shown to the user. This lets you craft the perfect email to send those photos out to your party attendees. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to set up and customize email and how to set up Dropbox so you can store all those emailed photos in a safe and secure location. Let's start with Dropbox. When you configure email to use Dropbox, Wifibooth will email your guests Dropbox links. Sending links instead of the photos themselves avoids large email attachments taking up space on your email account. Open the event settings and go to the Dropbox page. On the Dropbox page, click Sign In. Sign in to your Dropbox account and allow Wifibooth access. You should end up back in the Wifibooth app. Check that your sign in was successful. The sign in button should have changed to a sign out button. For emailing Dropbox links, you need to turn on at least the first option so that collages are uploaded to Dropbox. Optionally, turn on the second option to upload everything to Dropbox. If collages are configured to upload to Dropbox, then they'll be uploaded when someone takes an action on a collage, like printing it. If all photos are configured to upload, then in addition to collages, individual photos will be uploaded to Dropbox when they show up on the gallery screen. After at least one photo has uploaded to Dropbox, you'll see this on the gallery screen. Touch it to open it, and you'll find the link and, more importantly, a QR code. Did you know that guests can use the normal Apple or Android camera app to easily open the Dropbox link? Just point your phone at the QR code with the camera app open, and you're prompted to open the Dropbox link. Easy. Now that Dropbox is configured, let's configure email. Open the email settings page, and let's get started. To start off, let's set up our email account. The app's default settings are set for any Google-hosted email accounts such as Gmail or G Suite. Google accounts are entirely free, easy to set up, and seamlessly integrate with most of today's services. Because Wifibooth is optimized to work with free Gmail accounts, one option is to open a new Gmail account that you use specifically for your photo booth, like myphotobooth@gmail.com. If you are using a Google-hosted account, awesome. There's no need to change the server, port, or connection type. If you are using a non-Google email host, then you will need to contact your service provider and ask them to provide you with the correct SMTP server, port, and connection type settings. Next, enter your username in this space here. If you're using a Gmail account, your username will be the part of your email address before the at symbol. If you're using a G Suite account, your username will probably be your entire email address. For other service providers, it's best to check directly with your service provider to determine your username. Then comes your password. If you're on a Google account, leave this space blank, as you will authenticate your account directly with Google in a moment. If you're on a different service provider, then fill in this space with your email password. Next, let's check out some of the options available in this menu. First, we need to set the top option, which controls whether email is active or not and what type of email is sent. You can turn it off so guests can't enter their email. You can click Only Save, which will just save the guest's email to a list for you to use later. It's worth noting that the next two options also save the email addresses, but this option is for when you want the address saved and no actual email sent by the app. Dropbox link, which will upload the selected photos to a Dropbox folder and then send the guests a link. And lastly, as attachment, which will attach the chosen photo to an email and send that to the address the guest enters. We're going to set this to Dropbox link. If you get an error when you try to do this, make sure Dropbox is signed in, turned on, and that your email account is already configured. Next is to customize the email so that your brand stands out. In this field, you can enter a web link or URL to a logo of your choice. It must be a photo, no larger than 375 by 100 pixels, and publicly accessible. The background photo follows the same rules as the logo, except it must be 375 by 536 pixels. This field lets you change the subject of the email. Next is the body of the email. To change that, just delete the text in between the two P tags and replace it with whatever you want to say to your guests. Use of emojis is supported in this field and is strongly encouraged. This field is HTML enabled, so if you wish to include HTML formatting like those P tags, you can. You should send a test email to an address of your choice so you can test all of your choices out and see how they look. Next, these fields determine what words the app will prompt your guests with when they're asked for their email address. This one is the title text of the pop-up where the guest is asked for their email address, and this is the body text of the pop-up. After they've entered their email address, they will be shown a confirmation screen. You can change the text that they see in these two fields here. If you intend to send additional emails to your guests for marketing or business purposes, or to use their email address in any other way, then the confirmation screen is a great place to get the guests to give you their consent. And lastly, this option allows you to force guests to enter their email address before any other action can be taken, including printing. As with all these customizable options, there is default text already in those fields if you can't think of anything different you'd like to say or see. Next is to authenticate your email account. Close the settings page and you'll be asked if the email address you are using is hosted on Google. If it is, click yes, log in. Continue, sign in to your Google account. Allow Wifibooth to access your account. Although this does grant Wifibooth full access to your Gmail account, Wifibooth only sends email. And your email is all set up to send out photos to your guests. After your event is finished, check that you don't have any emails queued and waiting to send. Make sure your iPad is connected to the internet. Go to the event picker screen. Near the top, make sure you see files waiting to upload, none. So you've had a great event with great guests making amazing photos and many have entered their email addresses. How do you get the email addresses out of the app? Here's how. Open event settings and go to the email settings page. These two options here are where you access all the saved email addresses and where you can clear all the addresses. Email addresses are specific to the event. That's it for now. Remember that there are help articles available on wifibooth.com designed to guide you through setting up and using Wifibooth. There's also the Wifibooth community where you can ask questions, suggest new ideas, and see what others are doing with their photo booth setups.